BackgammonGalaxy.com presents Grandmasters Roasting Amateurs.
Hi guys, I'm Marc from Backgammon Galaxy. I'm a Grandmaster and I'm going to be commenting on this wonderful matchup against Hagadol from... Oh, he didn't give us his... Great Britain. And Ivan 9310 from Bulgaria. Okay, so let's see how these guys play and if we can spot some leaks in their game. And yeah, let's see what we can get out of this game. So we have a 5-3 to Hagadol. Okay, I guess he should just make the 3-point, right? Just make the inner point and make the hit. Yeah, good play, Hagadol. Not too difficult. That's a good roll. That's a good roll from Ivan. 6-1. Played safe. 14-8. Good. Oof. Double 5. Okay. So the decision is, do we run with both checkers to the 10 point? Or do we make the blitz and make two inner points? Okay, so Ivan opted for the running game. It makes sense since the cube is in the middle, but I think the right idea was to make the blitz. It's simply too strong. Double hit, make two inner points. So he doesn't even have a double here, Ivan. So I think he just made a big mistake not blitzing. Okay, he has to stack up on the 6-point. Not that he likes it, but that's what he gotta do. 5-1 to Hagadol. So I think I liked the ace more from 6-5, slotting, developing your front position, but it's not too bad creeping up to the 21 point as well. So Ivan has to stack even more. That's the only way not to leave a shot. He's not happy about this unflexible position with a stack and strip points. It's not exactly a flexible position. So now he needs to do something to get his checkers home safely. Okay, 4-3, not too bad. Yeah, he makes the right play, puts him down behind the anchor. 5-3, and of course Hagadol should just think about developing his front position as well as possible. Good play. And I guess Ivan is thinking about cubing. I would say it's still a little bit too early since the pip is just 12 pips, and it's not, he doesn't really have a good flexible bearing position. So double 3 definitely helps. So I guess you start by bringing these two checkers down, and you either make the 5 or just continue with the two checkers up to the 7 point. Let's see what he makes. Okay, he made a different move. Okay, yeah, it's not too bad. Doesn't look too bad. Oi, he just missed a big cube. Ivan, why didn't you double this position? You were up 17 pips. You cleared all the difficult points. Yeah, that was a big... Okay, so he still doesn't cube. Ivan, why don't you double? You have a gin position almost. This is like, you already lost your market. It's a big pass. It might even be too good, but I don't think that he's aware that it might be too good. I think he just doesn't think about the doubling cube. So let this be a lesson. Every roll is a cube decision. Every roll is a cube decision. Always think about the cube. So he continues not to double. This time he's right not to double because it's too good. So well played, Ivan, whether you know it or not. This is you're doing the right thing. But okay, yeah, now it comes. Ivan, this is too good. Ivan, you have no risk. You could have rolled a double 6 and left a shot, but it doesn't matter too much because you're not gonna win a gammon anyway. It's quite low gammon rates, but technically this was too good. So, yeah, What? Ivan is doubling. You didn't want to double before, Ivan. You waited until you were too good, and now you double on the first, on the second roll of the match. What the? Why? Okay, I don't understand that logic. It obviously is a big mistake. You don't want to give away the cube to the opponent at the second roll of the game. Now it's only he has all the cube value. You can't. The cube is a weapon you need to use as efficiently as possible. But now only your opponent has the access to it. So, not good. Double hit. Ooh, that's a good roll. Good roll, Ivan. You got a double hit. Double hit. He sees it. Good. Double two. This might have been a cube. Now you have a position that's good enough to cube. Double two. What a roll. Wow. Double hits and closes the 4 point. Okay. I and Hagadol fans. Again, this would be a good cube. 6-1. What about the ace? Where to play the ace? Where to play the ace? Yeah, good move. Good move. Okay, so he can't really... Of course, he should just cover up, make the 4 point board, and then play the inflexible ace here. Yeah. Hagadol fans, yet one more time. That's a good roll. Now we want to see the point shift. Come on. Let's see the point shift. Let's see the point shift. Funny enough, this is a move that beginners easily see, while intermediate players, they've been taught that these points, the higher points are the best points, so they are less likely to make it, but he did make the right play. Well done, Hagadol. And he just continues. This is going to be a gammon. This is going to be a gammon. So at least he did get the cube in, but it was a big mistake to give it that early in the game. You want to give the cube when your opponent still has a chance of taking it. If you wait until it's too good, then you lost your market. You're just going to win 1 point. So you want to give your opponent a tough decision. If your opponent can just take it without even thinking about it, it's probably not a good double. You should wait until you have a more efficient cube. When you double, you double up the stakes of the game. So you want to be sure that you are in a good, advantageous position that's not going to turn around too easily and let your opponent be in an advantageous position with the two cube on his side. Okay, this is just going to be a gammon, easy gammon win for Ivan. So let's see how Hagadol responds to being down 5-0-7. Yeah, of course, Ivan should just play as safe as possible here in the Baron. Just play it completely safe, Ivan. Don't leave yourself any bad double sixes. Very good play. Yeah. All he has to worry about is not leaving himself any bad rolls that might leave a shot. So here he's gonna, yeah, okay, so he has this unfortunate distribution here where he's gonna leave a shot if he rolls double five, double six, five, and or double four. Luckily he didn't. And he's gonna fan, double ace. I think I'm just gonna take two checkers off. It's not the safest play. You could, the safest play would, what the fuck? Nine. Ivan, what did you do? You opened up your ace point. And he even entered. Okay, Ivan, you could get hit now. You could even lose the game. That's not what you want to do. Never just open up like that. He opened up here on this ace point. He had a gin position. Okay, so... okay, he hasn't rolled an ace yet. But any ace will leave... Wow, the backgammon. Wow. Oi, ladies and gentlemen. this is why backgammon is so deceiving, because Ivan, to say it, to put it mildly, he literally misplayed this match as bad as you possibly could, but yet he won the match. He won the match. He's not gonna get any galaxy rating though, because he had the worst, he lost the error rate battle. Hagadol played a 10, which is decent. It's the experience level of play, while Ivan played as a beginner. Actually, Ivan's checker play, except for the Barov blunder that he made here at the end, was not that bad. It was the cube decisions for Ivan that that destroyed his error rate. Okay, guys, so that was a short video, since it was a short match, but that's the way it goes sometimes. Sometimes you win a backgammon on 2-cube, win 6 points. Yeah, so take care, see you next time, and don't forget to leave comments in the comment section.
Grandmasters, roasting amateurs. BackgammonGalaxy.com. Play among the stars. Available on browser, tablet, and smartphone. Subscribe to see more backgammon videos. Tell us which backgammon videos you want to see.